Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you why your artwork will sometimes change color when pasting from one Illustrator document to another Illustrator document. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I've opened a design that I've been working on, which is this text one, and it's got this pink Pantone color in it, which is PMS 709. And I've decided that I want to change this to a blue color. So I'm just going to double click on that. We'll change this to RGB, and then we'll just move the sliders a little bit. Okay, that looks good. And we'll say okay. Now let's stop right here and go over why this is a really bad idea to begin with. You'll see over in your swatches that Pantone 709 is now blue. And that is not what Pantone 709 is. It's that pink color. And no matter where you go in the world, Pantone 709 is always pink. It should never be blue. So when you're creating new colors, you should just always create a new swatch instead of recoloring a swatch that already has a name. So instead of doing that, we would want to just click our new swatch button and make changes, and we can rename it something else instead of a copy of 709. But let's say we didn't know that and we go ahead and recolor our Pantone 709 swatch. Okay, so let's select all this. I'm going to copy that. And now I'm going to open another design that I was working on that I want to put this text in. So I'm going to paste in front with Command F or Control F on a PC. And you may notice that Pantone 709 color has changed from blue back to pink. And that's because 709 already exists in this document. A lot of times this will happen when you've got two artists working on the same graphic. So one will change their color, and then when it's pasted into a different graphic, the one the other artist was working on, it'll change back, or it'll change to something that we don't want. In this case, it's the text, so it's pretty noticeable. But a lot of times, the color will be a subtle change, and it'll get printed with the wrong color, not the color the client wants or the artist really wants. So this will also work in reverse. Let's undo, and I'm just going to copy all of this artwork and then paste it into this. I'll hit Command B or Control B on a PC to paste behind. Now you can see that all of the pink that was colored with the Pantone 709 is now blue. And the reason I'm showing you this is because I want you to know that Illustrator doesn't default to the actual Pantone color. It'll default to whatever the original document has, which might be right or it might be wrong. It doesn't know what color PMS 709 should be. So anyway, just be really careful when you're changing your swatch colors. The names of these really do matter. All right, if you like the way I teach, I also have full courses out on Skillshare, and I have a link in my description that will give you a free 2-week trial if you've never been a member there before. And so you could use that and then take all my classes for free. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.